Today's episode is brought to you by Squarespace.
So here's the challenge. I have to try and make a game within 1 hour. I can't use any pre-made art, but I am allowed to use some sounds and some music if I want. But that's not all. After my first hour is up, I'll give myself 1 more hour to polish the game and add any finishing touches. Make sense? Time starts now. I started out by creating a project in Godot. I knew I wanted the game to be a platformer, so I created a player node, and I used the classic Godot icon as placeholder art. After that, I started coding in some gravity and basic movement for the player. I plopped in a couple platforms, then ran the game for the first time to see what would happen. The good news is that the movement seemed to be working fine, but for some reason, I wasn't able to jump. No matter how many times I pressed that button, nothing was working. So then I proceeded to waste the next 6 minutes trying to find out why I couldn't jump. But of course, as usual, the problem was very simple and I was just overthinking it. Most of you may know this, but if you don't, you always want to apply a negative y velocity, as that is the up direction, where positive is down. And that's what I was doing. Every time I pressed jump, my player was going down. Nice. So now that that mess was cleared up, I focused on trying to add rotation to my jumps. But why, you ask? My idea was to make a platformer where you were constantly trying to climb up, but every time you move left or right, you would rotate. So basically, you need to do flips to get onto the next platform and not hit your head. But that's when I got a little bit sidetracked on creating the player art. I was trying to resist the temptation of working on art.
Yeah, right, like that's gonna happen.
With that said, I have no idea why I made a T-posing man wearing a top hat, but let's just go with it. I also quickly made some artwork for the platforms and then added both those to the game. But how are we doing on— oh my gosh, we only have 30 minutes left and I still don't have a game. This is when I started to panic a little bit. I needed to go faster. It was time for me to go into game dev overdrive. And speaking of overdrive, did I mention you can make your dream website fast with today's sponsor, Squarespace? Making your own website or online store can be a huge pain in the butt from scratch. Believe me, I've done it many times before. And the best way to cut the hassle is to use Squarespace. From selling your products online, making a portfolio or gallery of your work, or even something as tedious as image scaling, is so much easier and saves you so much time with Squarespace. As the internet expands, I truly believe that everyone should have internet real estate, but creating your own website doesn't mean you have to be disconnected from social media. With Squarespace, you can connect your social profiles so that way you can instantly post on different platforms, making it fantastic and easy to post your new product or game. Make sure to go check out squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready, you're all set to launch, go to squarespace.com/goodgis to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Remember all that code I just wrote for jumping? Well, I kind of just threw it all away. I decided I wanted to switch my character to a rigid body, that way it had more realistic physics. And speaking of changing things, I also decided that instead of having to jump up the platforms, why not just roll down them? Easy. Next, I had to make the platforms move up and then add the rotation to the movement, and voila. That's not right. Okay, there we go. I made it so the platforms randomly spawn in the map. I also added a scoring system that increased every second that you survived. I also wanted the game to get harder as you played, so I made the platform speed up the more points you got. It looks like everything is coming together. Ooh, yeah, I love this silhouette. Oh yeah, this is looking great. Oh, I guess I forgot to add a way for you to actually lose the game, so I made it so the game restarts when you fall out of bounds or if the platforms take you too high. And also, at some point, I readjusted the window size so that— ooh, all right, I'm done. I felt like I barely had time to add in basic mechanics, and I totally even forgot to add sound or music. But for a 1 hour project, the game is fun. It's fun. It's fun.
Goodgis, I don't know how to tell you this, man, but this game is terrible.
I mean, this game in like an hour, so you—
I'm serious. This is one of the worst games I've ever seen.
Are you kidding me right now?
You know, I wish I was joking. I really do. You need to go back and change it or something.
Dude, I'm not gonna fix it. So I decided to spend 1 more hour polishing the game. And my time starts now. I knew that for the first hour, I wasted too much time working on art, but I needed more art for the game, so I just started working on it right away. I thought it'd be fun to add some variety to the platforms, so I made a couple coins and some lovely spikes. I just thought it was a fun idea that some of the platforms could hurt you while others gave you bonus points. I also created some tiles to show that you can't fall down or go up in the map, and then I changed the player to blue because I didn't want to confuse it with the spikes and the pit. I also quickly made these little tutorial arrows, and that was it for the artwork. I got to work quickly implementing the new platforms and coins, and then I randomized which platforms would spawn in, which just that alone made the gameplay way more fun. Before, I made the walls solid, and I felt like it made the game a little too easy, so screen wrapping was a good call. I thought a little tutorial would be nice. Basically, I just added arrows showing that you can move left and right. After that was one of the most important parts, adding in sound effects and music. The very last thing I did was just tweaking the spawn rates and platform speed until the game felt good. Also, just completely ignore that. That's nothing. So that's the end of my 1 hour game challenge. I'm really glad I tried the challenge out. Of course, I wish I had time to polish it up even more, as there's a lot of weird bugs and glitches where platforms are on top of each other, but it's fine. That's the whole goal of this challenge. It's not to make a great game, it's just to make a game. And if you want to push yourself or test your game dev skills, I would highly recommend that you try this challenge for yourself. And if you do, make sure to join my Discord and share your game. I would love to play it and see what you guys come up with. I also want to just give a huge shout out to James Albert, Skydes, Ryebread, and Heath Sargent, and the rest of the fantastic Patreon supporters for all your support. You make these videos possible, and I appreciate you guys so much. But that's it for me. Thanks so much for watching the video, and I'll see you next time for another Game Dev Adventure.